by Marika Savarese. The title is Charge and Proton Transfer Reactions, Insight from Theory.
Good afternoon to everyone. I want to thank first the committee for giving me the possibility to have this talk today. What we are going today to talk are charge and proton transfer reaction inside from theory. So the first topic will regard PCIT reaction and the methodological nowadays available tool to afford this kind of very complex reaction. And after this, we will pass to talk about excited states reactivity and tools which enable us to describe the reactivity on excited states. I want to start from the PCIT definition. PCIT are reactions in which a proton and electron transfer take place in a coupled way. So, they are very interesting, both for the electrochemical and the biological field. To study an example of a PCIT reaction, we decided to refer to a system which is which have been characterized from an experimental point of view by Professor Giese from Zurich, and he have built this peptide chain in which there is a tyrosine residue which act as a proton donor and electron donor, and a trimethoxyphenylalanine residue which act as electron acceptor. There is also a water molecule which act as the proton acceptor. We modeled this reaction and we decided to scan the potential energy surface along the oxygen hydrogen distance, and we follow the reaction along these coordinates, and we can follow also the progress of the electron transfer reaction by monitoring the spin density along the peptide chain. Here, okay. So we need an assessment of the from a methodological point of view, because we need to be sure that we are performing, we are describing well the reaction, and also we must take into consideration the environment in which the reaction we are simulating take place. Okay, here. There is an energetic profile along the oxygen-hydrogen distance performed with different level of theory. We, taking as reference the Hartree-Fock or MP2 level, we can observe that while the proton transfer takes place, the electron transfer, which is here represented by the red or the blue line, which means the red line represents that the unpaired electron is localized on the tyrosine residue, while the blue line represents indicate that the unpaired electron is localized on the trimethoxyphenylalanine residue. And so the change of color indicates that the electron transfer has taken place. And we can observe here that some functions are not able to locate the unpaired electron. And the green line indicates that the spin density is smashed up on the entire peptide chain. But if we want to mimic the presence of the solvent, we can do it by representing the water molecule in explicit way. So we performed an ab initio dynamic with a spherical box with about 11, 80 water molecules, and we take some snapshot of this dynamic as initial configuration, and we constructed the energetic profile that I show here. Again, we can observe that the Hartree-Fock curves represent both the proton and the electron transfer, while some functional seems to be not able to localize the unpaired electron. Okay, but we can use also an implicit solvent, implicit model to mimic the presence of the solvent. And here we can observe that global hybrid function that before will have been not able to locate the unpaired electron now behaves well. We hypothesize that this is because there is a compensation of error, of the self-interaction error with the representation of the solvent that is given by the implicit model. And this slide is a summary of the results that I have showed you previously. And this is to say that the percentage of Hartree-Fock exchange contained in the functional must be taken into consideration in the results that the combination with the model of the solvent produce. So to perform a calculation which regards a very complex reaction like PCIT reaction, a calibration of the methods is necessary as first step. And here I want to present the situation in which an hybrid implicit and explicit solvent is taken into consideration. So we have our peptide with some water water molecule represented explicitly and an implicit solvent. We can see here that going from a lower number of water molecules solvating the tyrosine residue to a greater number of water molecules solvating the tyrosine residue, to observe the electron transfer, it is necessary to take into consideration also excited states. So we are now facing the problem of analyzing very complex reaction and excited states. And the question is, nowadays, have we some tool to describe the reactivity on excited states? And to answer this question, we take as a reference a system which has been very recently characterized by Papanicolaou and co-workers from North Carolina, in which an excited state proton transfer between a coumarin, which acts as a proton donor, and a base molecule, which acts as a proton acceptor, take place only if irradiation is present experimentally. So, if we take a slice of the potential energy surface along the oxygen hydrogen distance, and we relax the whole structure on the ground states, we can observe that the energy of the product is not favorable compared to the reagent. But if we perform the same kind of relaxation on the first excited states, we can observe first the formation of an abduct and then the formation of the product with a very low energetic barrier. Okay, but here we have fixed only the oxygen hydrogen distance, but along these points we have observed that also a variation of the oxygen-nitrogen distance is involved. So we have built a potential energy surface keeping frozen the oxygen-hydrogen distance and the oxygen-nitrogen distance and relax all structure on the first excited states. What we can observe that going from the reagent to the product, two paths are possible. One involves only the elongation of the oxygen-hydrogen distance, and the second, first involves a decrease of the oxygen-nitrogen distance, and then an elongation. And this second is the minimum energy path. So now we want to describe this reactivity, this kind of path with tools. And the first tool we have taken into consideration is DCT index, which have been presented before by Professor Carlo Adamo. Here, I gave again the definition. We define a variation of electronic density for a fixed nuclear configuration. So we compare the excited and ground states density. So it's a vertical excitation. Then we can define two collection of points. One is the points in which there is an increment of the electronic density, and the other the points in which there is a decrement of the electronic density. We can define two barycenters, and very simply, DCT is the distance between these two densities. Okay, these are equations which enable us to calculate DCT. And here I'll plot the grids with, which I showed you previously, and its DCT values. We can observe that going from the reagent to the product, there is a decrement of the DCT index. And for the two possible paths, in correspondence, it seems that in correspondence of the transition state region is localized a maximum in the DCT value. But we are not able to, to individuate which of the two paths is the minimum energy path from this graph. So we decided to develop a new index, which has been named the DCT React. Now, DCT React is the comparison between the ground state electronic density calculated at the minimum energy structure of the first excited states and the electronic density calculated for each point of the excited states curve. I think that we need a picture to better understand what I've said, and this arrow connect points whose density are compared in DCT in its canonical definition, and DCT React in this case. Okay, now we can show the grid, the grid point of DCT React. So we again have oxygen nitrogen distance and oxygen hydrogen distance, and we calculated DCT React. We can observe that again there is a decrement of the DCT React values going from the reagent to the product, but if we focus on the reagent zone, we can observe that the minimum energy path is the one which corresponds to the steepest variation of DCT React. So it seems that this index is able to indicate which is the more favorable path on the excited states. In conclusion, I want to underline that to simulate very complex reaction like PCIT reaction or reaction which involves excited states, we need to calibrate very accurately the balance between the methodological level and the environment in which we are simulating our reaction. In density-based indices seems to be very promising to support the characterization of excited states reaction. And in our perspective, there is the formulation of new density-based indices, which would be helpful to characterize more complex reaction or to understand, to better characterize critical PEEs, potential energy surface region. And finally, I want to thank Nadia Rega Group and Carlo Adamo e Ilaria Ciofini Groups, Professor Nadia Rega for the time that she dedicated to my education, and you for your kindly attention. No, the reaction which I studied for the peptides is only for ground states. But if we study different cluster of the entire peptide and the number of water molecules, you need to invoke also excited states to see the electron transfer process. Yes.
But that implies physically that you have an electron rearrangement as the nuclei reach equilibrium positions, whereas what happens really is that the electron responds on the time scale of the nuclear motion to these interactions. Shouldn't there be some sort of non-adiabatic couplings in some region, maybe a simple one, just the derivative of the nuclear motions close to the points where you see the transition states, because I imagine that that will affect a lot the redistribution of the electronic charge.
This is a good question, because adiabaticity is very implied in this kind of reaction, and at the level of calculation of density reactor, we checked that density were calculated on the same green points for different nuclear configuration, and in this case, of this particular excited states reaction, it is involved only the first excited states. And so it has also a very characteristic, electronic structure. So we don't have this kind of problem for this reaction. But this is a topic that had to be explored.
Thank you.